Good afternoon. I'm meteorologist Hayley LaPoint. Here's a look at your updated forecast and an update on Irma as well. Today, we've got sunshine, some passing clouds, and there is the chance of a passing shower too later on in the afternoon. Should be very brief and light, though most of us will remain dry, so it'll be a pleasant September afternoon here. The reason we have the chance for passing clouds and showers, this low pressure system, it's actually an upper level low pressure system that continues to pivot through the Great Lakes region, and each time it's kind of pivoting around, it's throwing a few showers and extra cloud cover our way. So this afternoon and then also tomorrow, we have the risk of passing showers too. It's also a bit on the cooler side in the 60s in the North Country. Low humidity though, so pleasant we'll call it. In the low 70s, Concord, Manchester, about 71 degrees in the Salem area. For the weekend forecast, Saturday, lots of clouds, probably more clouds than today, but there will be some sunny breaks. You'll be able to see the blue sky from time to time. And again, a spotty shower in the afternoon possible. Look at the temperatures, only in the 60s across the state, so a little bit cooler. Sunday will start to bring the temperatures back up, upper 60s to the north, 70s in central and southern locations. It'll be bright and sunny. It should be dry on Sunday. All right, here's the latest on Irma. It is still a Category 4 hurricane as of 11 a.m. You can see it starting to move away from the Turks and Caicos now, but obviously a very well-defined eye there, a sure sign that this thing's still packing a big punch as it's continuing to move just to the north of Cuba and through portions of the Bahamas. We have hurricane warnings that have been posted now for areas just to the north of Miami, including the Keys and up to about Naples, Florida. So it looks like landfall will be somewhere between probably Key West and Miami once we get into the late night hours on Saturday and into Sunday morning. Here are the latest stats on Hurricane Irma. 150 mile per hour winds, so the winds have gone down a little bit. The movement's still very slow to the west northwest, about 14 miles per hour. And here's the latest track. Now, the track has shifted just slightly since the last advisory this morning, just a little bit more to the west. This is actually not good news for places like Homestead and then into Miami, because that front right quadrant of the storm is where you have those real strong winds. So if it's tracking more to the west like it is, that would bring the strongest winds right into Miami and to communities just to the south of Miami. And that looks like the timing would be early on Sunday morning. Then the whole thing continues to just track right up through the spine of the state of Florida, right over Orlando, eventually over Jacksonville. So really no one in Florida left out. But the good thing is it does weaken significantly as it moves on land down to a Category 1 by the time it reaches the northern parts of the state. And then it moves into Georgia and parts of the Carolinas with just rain expected there. For us, we have some very quiet weather. Again, just a small chance of a shower on Friday and into Saturday. Sunday will be dry with temps of the 70s, and then it looks like we warm up a bit Monday and Tuesday with temperatures approaching the 80s and then a little bit above the 80s on Tuesday.